Yells.
Hey guys, Wake Rider here, playing a little bit of Sect Control at Kandahar Marketplace. And this is Medal of Honor, of course. And as we are all kind of gearing up and hoping and praying that Medal of Honor 2 is just so awesome, I want to bring you guys a little different game mode, because I've been bringing you all of Team Assault. And Team Assault is really like Team Deathmatch. And Team Assault is kind of what Battlefield's new Team Deathmatch is based off of. So you see here I'm capturing this objective. It's kind of like Domination and Call of Duty. However, I would say it's closer to actually Conquest on Battlefield, but just on a very small Team Deathmatch size map. So it's very close quarters. This game is low hit to kill, and it is just an absolute blast. We do a pretty good job of keeping this team at bay with maybe only capturing one objective. I think they captured two for maybe like 30 seconds this entire match. And this match actually lasted a little longer than this video. I think it's about a 13 to 14 minute gameplay, but I have it chopped down to about 9 minutes right now. But yeah, the game mechanics were a little flawed up there. They kept spawning in their original spawn, so I kind of took advantage of it. Grabbed a couple extra kills, so I go ahead and get some perks for my team and hopefully help bring home the W. And using the M16 with the ACOG scope, or they call it the battle scope in this particular game, but it's basically the ACOG scope. And the M16 is probably one of the best guns in the game, especially if you're using the Rifleman class, which is basically, if you equate to the battlefield, it's kind of like your assault class. So the Rifleman class, you have the new tube or the 203s, and then you also have the larger assault rifles, AK-47, M16, F-2000, stuff of that nature. But it's a lot of fun though, man. I mean, I played this game. I got so into Sector Control because I hadn't played Sector Control in forever. I got so into Sector Control, I played this all day on my day off. Like, I was supposed to go out and run a couple errands. I wanted to play a couple other games. After the first day, I rented my server. I wasn't even playing on my own server. I'm sitting here playing a two-year-old game in a game mode I haven't played in about 2 years the entire day. Almost. Probably for about 4 hours I played this game. And, you know, I have off Tuesdays, for those of you that don't know. So it's like, what do you do on Tuesday? All my friends are at work. My girlfriend's at work. There's nothing to do but take care of the little... Get headshotted. There's nothing to do but take care of, like, the little bit of stuff I need to and play games. So that's usually when I get all my gameplays. But, so you see, the maps are laid out pretty cool. It's just really a lot of fun, this game here. And now, if you are planning on getting Medal of Honor 2 Warfighter, I would recommend picking this game up. You can get it on the cheap right now. I think you can probably get this game for about $10 to $12, depending on where you look. Of course, I think you know, if you go on an internet site like Half.com or Amazon, you can probably get it real cheap. It does require an online pass, so you will get capped off if you do not have an online pass. So just be careful of that. You know, if you get a sealed copy, of course it comes with it, but if you get a used copy, you may have to buy an online pass. And I think the pass for this game is about $3 to $5. So it's not huge, but just keep that in mind if you are planning on getting it. You know, make sure you don't have to spend $20 and then spend an extra $5 on an online pass. You know, $20 should be definitely with an online pass. But I picked this game up at GameStop for $15 for Xbox recently, so you really shouldn't have too much trouble getting it on the cheap, like I said. You see right there, called it a Mortar Strike, and for those of you who are unfamiliar with this game, your kill streaks, quote-unquote kill streaks, you have the choice of choosing between either a lethal kill streak or a helpful kill streak to your team. So I'm a little greedy, so I choose the Mortar Strike over the UAV. And there's no ghost, there's none of that crap in this game. The best thing you can do to hide off the minimap is to put a silencer on it, but a silencer really does dampen your overall damage. especially at a distance. And I actually am running a silencer on this M16. The way Medal of Honor plays is actually you play twice on the same map and you flip-flop sides. One time you're the Americans, and then the next time you're the insurgents, and you start off in each other's spawn and everything. So you get to play both sides. Now what I do is, just to see what works better for me, is usually with the insurgents I run an AK-47 or something with a silencer, and then when I flip-flop over to the without a silencer, and then when I flip-flop over to the American or the special forces side, then I strap on a silencer just to see if there's any difference, see if the team, how closely the team is paying attention, how aware they are. So this works out pretty good. The game before this, I think I did okay. So, obviously the team's not MLG Pro. It's not All-Stars by any means. But I just had a lot of fun. Like I said, I played this game almost all day. It was one of those things, man. And I'm sure, you know, if you guys have been playing games for long enough, that's just totally oblivious. Both of us just totally miss each other. I got lucky. But it's one of those things, if you've been playing games for a while, and I'm sure most of you guys have, that you just lose track of time. You know, you think you're playing for an hour, or you say, hey, just one more game, and it ends up being 2, 3, 4, and next thing you know, it's time to eat. But just an absolute blast. And like I said, and I don't think I finished my thought on this, but if you are planning on getting Medal of Honor 2 Warfighter, I recommend paying on this game just so you can kind of learn the game modes. And also learn a bit of the setups. I'm not sure if they're going to have the same class setup. There's really not a whole lot confirmed right now, except for the fact that it is coming out in October, November timeframe. I know they said, I think they said October, but I think this game they said October 2 and actually came, or August, and it came out in November. So just be prepared. I mean, most of these games do get pushed back slightly. So it's just something that kind of comes with the territory. So I'm expecting it to be out in October, November-ish time frame, which is going to be a great time frame because Black Ops 2 is going to be out. And I think this game will give a lot of people who are just kind of sick of Call of Duty, not quite full-on Battlefield with the huge maps and, you know, the tanks and all that stuff, but I think it's going to give a lot of people a little bit of Battlefield, and maybe just enough to, if you really like this game, to be tempted to go buy Battlefield 3. And of course, Battlefield 3, as we pretty much all know, is an awesome game. So I think it's, in my personal opinion here, I'm just kind of, you know, shooting out theories, but I think it's a good way for EA to have a little bit of retention of your customers on Battlefield 3. And I think it's also going to help give people another shooter this fall that will allow people to experience a little bit different flavor of a shooter. A little more tactical version. Not just this cartoony, never changed in the last, you know, 5 years game. I think we've all grown a little bit tired of it. I mean, you know, you hear all these big YouTube commentators that do nothing but Call of Duty videos, you know, bitching and complaining about their views going down, their subs going down, and everything else. So obviously that equates to their revenue's going down from views as well. Just people are getting sick of Call of Duty, man. I mean, they just are. I mean, I still enjoy it here and there. I use Call of Duty as a break from other games. I don't play Call of Duty and then play Battlefield when I'm bored. You know what I mean? So I'm glad my channel has always been pretty diverse. So you can see there, ended up 23-5. Got a couple caps. We held them pretty good at to about one flag the whole game. So let me know what you think. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Now you guys pretty much know how this works. If you haven't subscribed already, please feel free to go ahead and click subscribe, and that will bring my nice variety of FPSs right to your YouTube homepage. Video on the right is another Modern Warfare 3 video using the Golden MP7 running specialist class on Resistance. I hate that map. And the video on the left is actually a Medal of Honor video using the AK-74U. So please feel free to click away. And of course, random will be maybe it's Homefront, maybe it's another Call of Duty, an old one, a new one, who knows, or an old Battlefield, a new Battlefield, who knows. That's why it's random, right? And also, please feel free to check out some of my French channels. I'll put links to them down in the description. Thanks, guys.
Yells!